posted into the service tax register. This register is also automatically maintained. This is the service tax register. Whatever you are doing, everything is automatically coming whenever the payment is done. Which you don't have to make multiple entries for the same transaction, for account separate, for inventory separate, for excise separate. No need. In one entry, everything is getting posted. This is the, and every report is transferred to the Excel. Every report. So you can just check it out. This is the DSA register. Okay, this is the DSA register. Whatever you are making, this, some companies have the habit of showing zero closing balance at month end. Some are showing actual what it is. So we can have the both the options. That if you want a zero closing balance, we can give you the zero closing balance as it is shown in the screen. If you want what actually lying in my stock, we can do that also. Here you can have everything as on date as per the excise rules, whatever the columns and everything. You can directly just show the excise auditors and everything. Some companies have done that, means the excise audit was there, they have just shown it on the system. In Mumbai, there was a client, they had the sudden visit from the excise department. They were just asking whatever softwares, whatever we have, just show it. They have every, the whole day for audit was done on the system. Everything they checked, they were satisfied with this. Here is one more special report that we have done. This is a tariff-wise sales report. This is a summary report. DSA is what? Day-wise, first of, second, third, fourth, fifth. This is a summary report. Means whatever the sale is there for the summary, for that tariff, whatever the quantity, the amount, P&F applicable, SENVAT, sales, excess, whatever the taxes were there. Everything in a summary report for the excise purpose. Then this is a debit entry. Whatever the invoices are there during this month, here you will see these figures are automatically coming from the GRN and everything. This is the sales part, whatever you have to payable, and this is available in the credit, means input, capital, service tax, CLA, whatever is there. And here you are debiting the values. Whatever, this is the only one entry you have to pass every month. And accounting posting, for the same entry, accounting posting will also be automatically captured. So this is the only one entry regarding the excise. This is a rough one more. The, in subcontracting out, you have to maintain a 4-5 day register, the job working, whatever is going on, going out and whatever is coming in. So that also is captured from the GIN GDN module, the subcontracting out module. Whatever is going out, whatever is lying at third party, whatever 120 was out, 10 is back, whatever, what was the 4-5 day challan number and everything. And this PLA register, whatever is the PLA entry happening, whatever we are debiting from the PLA, whatever challans we are, GR7 challan, TR6 challans, whatever debits are there, that also is captured. This is the ER1, what is the summary of all our excise module, whatever you have to submit every month, the ER1 module. Here you will get everything, means here the first screen was the sales detail, whatever we have saved, the tariff as per the excise format. The second, the intermediate transfer, the duties paid from the PLA and everything, the abstract. And this is the SENVAT abate, whatever is there, everything is captured. Means this, the special thing is that no, you don't have to do any entries, everything is captured automatically. The reports are generated automatically, you just have to check out the report, check out the figures and submit. Okay, next, in the excise module, this is, next is the VAT and sales. As I said about the excise, same is about the VAT and sales tax module. That there is no need of doing multiple entries again and again. Everything is captured from invoice, say GRN, GIN. Yeah, this is when we have an option of C-form tracking. Everyone has this headache that C-form, konsa pending hai, konsa liya hai, konsa diya hai. Kuch samajh nahi aata kiska pending hai. This, we have a facility that C-form tracking. Whatever material we have sold on the C-form, we can track that. And whenever we have received a C-form, we can update the entries that this is, yeah, we have received, we have not received. We have the filters of received and not received, everything, so that we can tracked. And in other case also, whatever we have to supply the three forms, that also we have the both the side, purchased and sales. You can track this, and we can also generate the reminder later also for that automation. This is the VAT report, means we have two types of VAT reports. One is a summary report, means whatever the purchase total amount, and this is a detailed report, both sides, purchase and sales, means whatever the invoice number, PO number, whatever the taxes number, as per the standard formats which are we can submit directly to the sales tax department, whatever in the required format. This is a C form tracking. Here you have this option, means purchase, sale, receive, not receive, means you can change it, you can change the status, everything. You can generate the reminders also from this. Suppose a party is there for a quarter, you have 10 forms pending from him. You can just generate, select those parties and generate a reminder for them. System will automatically generate a reminder. You can just add it to the your mail, or system can also just directly mail it. Automatic posting of VAT and everything, GL posting also. Okay. This concludes the VAT and sales tax. As I said that you can generate the email. We have a special mail, as Guru was saying, that alerts, means internal alerts. If the management needs some alerts, whatever the, what is the today's dispatch? I will not ask the sales guy every day that what is the sales, what is the sales today, what is the sales today. At the end of the day, automatically he wants an email. This today's, there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 invoices and dispatch, amount is 2 lakhs. Every day, automatically, pending ORI, the report will go to the production. Whatever. Means as you want the email alerts internally within your organization, you want some pending ORI, you want some non-moving items, depend, bank balances. Accounts manager wants what is the bank balance current position today. Every day at the evening or every weekend he wants a position, that the system can automatically generate an email to the concerned person. Automatically. You just have to mark this into the email alert module that this email should go to this person on this date, means on this after 4 days, after 8 days, every, you can define the period.
Non-moving items also.
Everything, means you can define, we have defined 8 to 10 alerts as like that, you can define, you can tell, you know, I want this alert also, we can add it. Not that if we have only 8 alerts, you can define, we can add it. If the logic is there, we can generate an email, not a problem.
The system is much, creating a PDF and sending
also. Yeah, that also is possible, that I am coming to it. Here, this is just an example that it's the two items, the reorder level is going down, just an example, okay. One new, we have done that, whenever I am making an invoice, I will click on a button, send email, automatically the PDF will be prepared for that invoice and it will be dispatched to the concerned email ID in that customer master. Same with, we can do with PO, same we can do with ORI, that we have received the copy, we just check it out. But in this case, one thing I would like to add, do not use the pre-printed stationery, because whenever if your invoice is pre-printed, it will show as fill in the blanks, means it will show customer name something, but the customer will not understand what is that, what is the quantity, which is the ray, what is in that row, what, which is the quantity and which is the amount. So we prefer for this purpose, we will create the system generated invoice so that the customer can understand what is the exact copy. Yeah. So if it is pre-printed, then it's not much use for the customer. You can generate the you can generate the PDFs, means whatever the documents are there. You can say PO, you can say GRN. GRN also you can do, some companies are practicing. Whenever we are making a GRN, they are sending the PDF to the customer that yes, 100 quantity was there, 90 accepted, 10 rejected, debit note will be sent. Whatever the GRN is there. Means every document you can generate a PDF through a mail through the person concerned departments also. And one thing, here what is happening, that suppose the Tata Motors is there, Tata Motors, there are 10 persons who gives you the order, okay, 10 persons who are giving you the order, but you, this order is for X, this order is for Y. In that case, you have 10 IDs, but the concerned person is there in the ORI. So the mail will go to the concerned person only. It will not get confused that this person or that person, because we have only one customer, Tata Motors. But the concerned persons are 10. In the ORI, you have the option of selecting the concerned person, so that it will go to the concerned person only. So this can be captured, means the PDF is there, same as the SMS. Today everyone is receiving PA, this alert, TD, this alert, TD, everything is coming. So we can generate an SMS. Means whatever we have prepared the invoice, okay, we have prepared the invoice, put the LR number and dock date, you can just click a button, the SMS will be sent to the concerned person. Yes, your invoice number is 0010, the your LR number this, courier number, courier name is this, it will be reaching 2 days, whatever. You can generate the outstanding, you have run the outstanding report. You can just send the click a button and send the SMS to the customer that your outstanding is this much, please arrange something. Or you can say, send a thankful message that you have received a payment, just thank you for the payment. Anything, means anything what you can do with an SMS, and it will not cost you much. Just a simple thing, you just have to, today is a days of mobile, just whatever you are seeing in the mobile. So you can just click a message and you can go. Everything is possible here. So
you can even get your stock statement from here.
Yeah, whatever, means you are intending of that thing, if some very important material. You can get it from the system also. You are getting a stock, you can add to this. If you are asking for some X item stock, you can just click on a button, ask the operator, I want this stock, you will just send a message, you will get the message. So whatever the applications you can think, it can be integrated. So we have this email alerts and this module, so then whatever applications you can think, it can be generated through the system. Okay?